picture this. You're living your life like a big time hotshot who thinks they'll never go missing, and the next thing you know, you're missing. Everyone starts looking for you, but they can't find you. They think you're dead, they have a funeral, and then you show up like, guess what? I'm not dead, I'm still alive, and you put on sunglasses. Well, that would be the best case scenario, but most of these stories are 10 times darker. Hello again, Most Amazing Top 10 family. I'm your host, Chad Arena, and welcome back to Most Amazing Top 10. Today, we're gonna be looking at people who walked back from the dead with our list of top 10 mysterious people who disappeared and came back. Make sure you stick around until the end of this video because I'm going to be answering some questions from my Instagram inbox, and make sure you click right over here to check out our new channel, Top 10 Central Vibe. It's a comedy reaction channel starring me. It's me all the time. Here's a clip. Just like blup, blup, blup. Oh, and that was for sure poo. This is going to be Top 10 Central Vibe. Hope you guys like it. It's going to be starring me. Me all the time. We're in the Illuminati. And without taking any longer, let's get into this list. Coming in at number 10, we have Amanda Eller. Imagine going for a hike, getting lost in the forest in Maui for 2 weeks, and then coming back like a G. Well, that's what Amanda was able to do. She was on a hiking trip out in Makawao Forest Reserve, and out of nowhere, she was gone. People went looking for her, but they couldn't find her. A helicopter was sent out, and they still couldn't find her. Her family put up a $50,000 reward to find her, and she was still nowhere to be found. Then, 2 weeks later, a helicopter was doing one of the final swoops to find this poor girl, and there she was. She was limping and waving her arms in the air. They swung down and scooped her up, but how did this woman manage to survive in the woods for 2 weeks without any supplies? And why did she go missing? Well, Amanda actually studied the local vegetation, was able to figure out what she could and couldn't eat, and she survived on cantaloupe. So think about that next time you don't want to eat that little orange fruit that could save your life. And the reason she went missing was because she fractured her leg while she was on the hike. I think it's safe to say that this lady is as tough as nails. Coming in at number 9, we have Petra Pasiska. One day, Petra just disappeared. She was gone and no one knew where she was. This was in 1984, so there weren't cameras on every street corner or any social media to try and reach out to her. Her family searched and searched for her, but she was gone, and it seemed that she would never be found. She didn't pop up until 2015, so I think it's safe to say that this lady is one of the hide and seek champions of the world. The reason she was found is because she had a break-in and she called the police. When the police asked her for ID, she didn't have anything, and then the whole truth came spilling out. She had ran away years ago and just hid herself from everyone. When asked how she was making money, she didn't tell anyone anything. And when her family tried to reach out to her, she refused to talk to them or tell anyone the reason she ran away. Coming in at number 8, we have Carlos de Salazar. Here's the thing, sometimes people just want to be left alone. They have no interest in hanging out with people, and they just want to go live in the forest for the rest of their lives. Now, if those people were to tell people that they're going to go live in a forest forever, everyone would try to stop them. So they just take off, and that's kind of what Carlos de Salazar did. One day, the Spanish man was just gone. His family was looking everywhere for him, but they couldn't find him anywhere. Then, 20 years later, some mushroom pickers in Italy came across this dude who had been living in the forest as a hermit. They spoke to the man for a little while, and turns out it was Carlos de Salazar. What the F? Why was this dude all the way out there? Well, it turns out he just wanted to be alone forever. But these guys still contacted the police, who contacted his family, who flew out to Italy to try and find him. But by the time they got there, the hermit had gone and hidden himself again and has never been seen since. Coming in at number 7, we have Angela Hernandez. I don't know how long I would last in the wild, but some of these stories are giving me hope that I wouldn't die right away from exposure because I'm a soft boy. Angela Hernandez was driving through California to visit some of her family. She was staying in contact with them, letting them know when she was on the road and when she was stopping off somewhere. Her family got worried when she stopped updating them, and then they got really worried when she never arrived, so a search was launched. A week went by without any contact with Angela, and people started to fear the worst. But then a destroyed SUV was found, and not far from it was Angela Hernandez. She was alive. She had driven off the side of a cliff and survived the crash, but she was too injured to move very far. She managed to salvage some some material from her car to make a hose so she could drink water and keep herself from dying from dehydration. Coming in at number 6, we have Gabriel Mackey. All the evidence here pointed to Gabriel being murdered, but the story was even crazier than that. Gabriel called his wife in 1987 and told her he was on his way home and the two expected to see each other soon. He never showed up. The police went searching for him, but they couldn't find him. Then his burnt out car was found and it looked like someone might have killed him and destroyed his car to cover up their tracks. He was gone for 20 years and then they found him through a search for medical records that flagged his name. He was tracked down and then he was able to give his story once he remembered who he was. Gabriel was in an accident that day and the accident caused him to go into a fugue state. He forgot who he was and his entire life. He made up a new identity and started to work on a dock in Australia. It wasn't until a private eye who tracked him down started to show him pictures of his family that he started to remember who he was. Coming in at number 5, we have Robert McDonough. This worked out so perfectly, it almost seemed like a prank. Robert McDonough was in his 70s and started to show signs of dementia. One day he just disappeared and his family imagined the worst. The older man was wandering into the streets and would never be seen again. A search was launched and after 14 hours of knocking on doors, putting up posters and following clues, it would seem that no one was going to be able to find him. The news picked up the story and was letting the public know that this older man was missing and if you see him you should let the authorities know right away. Well, in that moment, everyone saw Robert wandering into the shot. Talk about making an entrance. Coming in at number 4, we have Trapped. This story should be made into a movie because it's an absolutely insane survival story. A soccer team composed of boys between ages 11 and 16 were crushing it at soccer practice. These guys were going to become big stars, but nature wanted to test the resolve even more than a dribbling course. During practice, a monsoon rain started to come down and the entire team decided to hide in a cave for shelter. Well, the flooding got so high that they were forced deeper into the cave and then they were trapped in there because the flooding blocked the exit. For 9 days, they were trapped in there and no one knew where they were. Someone managed to put the pieces together as to where the missing soccer team went and a team of Navy SEALs went in with scuba gear to rescue the kids and the coach. Coming in at number 3, we have Edgar LaTulip. This was a missing persons case that everyone just threw aside when Edgar LaTulip went missing. See, Edgar had been struggling with his mental health for a long time, and on more than one occasion, he was submitted to a mental institution. While there, he repeatedly tried to take his own life, and then one day, he just disappeared. People looked for him for a little bit, but everyone just assumed that he was successful in his suicide. 30 years passed, and then out of nowhere, someone made a claim that they were Edgar LaTulip, who had been missing all of this time. And guess what? They actually were. What happened was Edgar suffered a serious head injury and forgot who he was and spent the next 3 decades living as a different person. He started to remember his life through flashbacks. Coming in at number 2, we have Elizabeth Smart. This was a terrifying case of a young girl being taken right from her home. Elizabeth Smart was sitting in a room and then out of nowhere, a man burst in with a knife. Elizabeth was terrified and didn't want to die, so she just sat there in shock as the man took her by the arm and dragged her out of the house. Next thing you know, this poor girl was gone. A search was launched, but no one could find out what happened to this poor girl. She might have been lost to the world forever if she didn't have one of the craftiest sisters of all time. Elizabeth's sister shared a room with her and was hiding under the covers when her sister was abducted. She managed to get a good look at the guy's face before he kidnapped her sister. This man was Brian David Mitchell. He was from the neighborhood and now his face was plastered all over the country. It took 9 months, but eventually the two were spotted together and Mitchell was arrested. See, Mitchell was starting a cult and in his mind he wanted to take Elizabeth as his bride for his cult. He did horrible things to her while she was kidnapped, but thank God they were able to rescue this girl alive. And coming into the number 1 spot, we have Nugent Thee Van. There's a lot of ways you can punish your kids, but be careful how you do it because sometimes the results can be devastating. Nguyen was living in Vietnam and her parents wanted to make her stop coming home late after school. Nguyen had a bad habit for staying out with her friends until the wee hours of the morning. This led to her parents locking her out, but she wasn't about to whine and moan. She went out and partied with some friends. On the way home, a woman offered her a ride, which she took, and then this woman drugged her. Nguyen woke up in China and then was sold to a strange man who took her for 21 years before she could escape. All right, everyone, that has been the list. Now I'm going to answer some questions. Pretty Face K wrote in and asked, what are your thoughts about these questions? I really like answering the questions, actually. You guys get very creative. Some of the questions are a little bit nasty, but I only answer those ones on my Instagram. They aren't family friendly for this channel. Another person wrote in, we all know you are dating fellow host Eamon. Not a question, but you guys are so wrong. I know you guys want that to be true so bad, but it just isn't. I have a strict rule that I never start anything romantic with anyone I work with because there's too much of a chance for it to blow up in my face. And finally, Wrestling Lockscreen wrote in and asked, can you become a full-time comedian? And I have to say, I'm definitely working on it. It will happen down the road, but right now comedy is in such a weird place because we can't gather and who knows how long it will be before things are back to normal. All right, everyone, that has been our list. Thank you all so much for tuning in. As always, I would love it if you could like, comment, subscribe, and hit the little notification bell. Until next time, I've been your host, Chaterena, and try to not go missing. It's bad.